mostly I just sit here and go, like, why? Why? I'm just confused by it all, if I'm being honest. Heartbroken and wish it never happened.
To say that Guy Sebastian has had a rollercoaster a few years is a hell of an understatement. It's seen not only the passing of a much-loved band member, Luke Liang, only for Sebastian to go on to win Song of the Year at the Arias. Meanwhile, Guy's ex-manager, Titus Day, is currently facing dozens of charges, accused by police of ripping Sebastian off by more than $1 million. And yet, somehow, Guy Sebastian has made it through the other side with the release of a brand new album.
Because there's been unbelievably positive moments and then some pretty, like, strange and tough things to navigate through as well. It just feels good to get it out there.
I'm told that on the first day of writing or recording that you were pretty much in tears beforehand. Can you, like, you just want to take me back and kind of explain what was going on?
Yeah. I mean, it's... I went through a pretty public breakup with management. Management relationship, it's very unique. You have to bear all of your weaknesses and warts and all for them to effectively manage you. And so you become very close, but in particular in this instance, our kids were best friends. Mostly I just sit here and go, like, why? Why? It was such a great thing that we had going. And I just don't understand. I'm just confused by it all, if I'm being honest. Heartbroken and wish it never happened.
How do you rebuild trust?
When something that has been your foundation for a long time is ripped away from you in such a strange fashion, you feel like you can't do what you do anymore. I was closed off to everyone for a while. I didn't know who to trust. And like even walking into a studio, to write, like downstairs is the Sony Studios. It's where I wrote the first song on this album, which is Before I Go. So I'm going in there thinking, what if I've forgot how to do this properly? What if I go into this session, I'm just useless? Like it was all those insecurities. And when you get screwed over or betrayed, that person who does that to you wins if you let them rob you of the ability to let other people into your life. So I refused to do that. And then I wrote the lead single of the album, which in the first session. Yeah, you thought you had me. You thought that I was done, but I'm stronger up against the road. That song is basically about saying, I am in control of this. So I think all that emotion actually worked for me, and then it gave me something to draw fuel from.
One of your songs that I think you'll probably always be best remembered for will be Choir. And Choir was written for somebody quite specific, Luke, who was in your band and passed away. For somebody that never met Luke, right, how would you go explaining what was it that made him special to you?
He just was an incredible, selfless person. There's a lyric in the bridge where it says, someday I know my friend, I'm going to see you again, and when I do, you better have a part for me. You take the melody and I'll take the harmony. That to me is the analogy of him always being the guy that's behind the artist, that's taken the harmony, playing second fiddle. And so, yeah, the next time we sing, he can take the lead. And it's always tough to get through that bridge. It's kind of something that I've got to switch off a little bit. And yeah, it's just a hole that is never filled.
It's been a bigger conversation in the last year, in particular, about mental health in the music industry, and I think it goes without saying the music industry's had a really rough year. What would you like to change about the way we talk about mental illness, particularly with musicians?
Well, look, whether it be music or really any other field, I think what people desire is purpose. And so throughout this pandemic, I think it's almost been thrown in the face of the arts that they're not essential. But whenever something goes wrong, musicians are called upon, whether it be bushfire relief concerts or kids with cancer, with hospitals. I mean, musicians are always there, and their purpose is to help. Their purpose is to provide respite, to lift people out of things that they're going through, to listen to that song when you're going through heartbreak. But somehow I feel like throughout this pandemic, a lot of the purpose has been taken away, and they're wondering whether what they do is important in the world. And I think it's very important to remind them that it is absolutely essential. Thank you guys, especially to your Prime Minister, for listening. You know, you mentioned that you guys were listening, and you really were, and that was evident.
A couple of months ago, you appeared with the Prime Minister, Scott Morrison, at an arts event, and I'm curious about the decision-making process of that, because obviously the moment you appear with any politician of any party, there's a degree of flack that comes with that.
Guy Sebastian is now the Scott Cam of the music world.
So what was it about that that you decided was so important, you did want to be a part of it?
I'd be lying if I said I knew that there would be flack. Like, I didn't even think of that.
Like, really?
I've never done that. I don't really align myself politically with anyone, and that wasn't about aligning myself with anyone. That was just literally thinking about how we can champion some kind of stimulus package to help the arts. And you have to speak to the person that's in charge. So in the moment, I thought, oh, this is great. This is unprecedented. It's never been done before. $250 million stimulus package to the arts. So then there was this really massive backlash that I wasn't prepared for. I didn't know that would happen. So I guess it was a lesson learned that, yes, if you stand next to a politician, there's going to be conversations had afterwards. I wish there was more being done, like everybody in the arts. But in saying that, I'm not going to stop. We're throwing everything at the wall. Tax breaks, GST breaks. We're thinking of some ways to do it. And if I've got to stand with our Prime Minister to try and get something that's going to help my peers in the arts, I'll do what I can. I'm standing with you tonight. Because I've had a great life. Like, you imagine starting your life, my career, the way I started it. Literally people going, I like how you sing. I'm going to spend 55 cents of my money that I earn so that you can do that for a living.
About 100 of those dollars is literally just my mum.
Exactly. But everyone tells me those stories. Oh, you owe me, mate. I was broke that month, blah, blah. So that I could do this for a living? Imagine starting like that. You've got this huge level of gratitude and appreciation. It's literally the fuel. My loyalty is with this gift that I've been given, and I've got to do the best I can with it.
Guy Sebastian, thank you so much. Hey, if you enjoyed that, make sure you subscribe to the Feed's YouTube channel.
And you can watch these videos here. See you next time.